Live from the Sun City Super Bowl, a golden welcome to 50 years of Miss South Africa. We salute 5 decades of fabulous fashion by national icons of the industry. The 60s meant the summer of love and man on the moon. Elspeter Rosenworth married European flair with South African earthiness to produce a sophisticated local style. The 70s gave us disco and platform heels. Peter Soldato scooped the fashion Oscar and clothed Miss South Africa 1975 in his highly individual creations. Brought us power dressing and designer jeans. Errol Arends polished local glamour into an internationally recognized brand and gowned many of the visiting celebrities. The 90s were marked by the rebirth of our country in freedom, the World Wide Web, and the Wonder Bra. Marion Fassler celebrated our continent with humor and spots before her eyes. The first decade of the new century is the century of Africa, with MP3 players and loads of bling. Sun Goddess draws on the colors of our entire continent, making them luxurious, sensual, and uniquely South African. welcome your host for the evening. She's a former Miss South Africa and a golden businesswoman. He's a multi-talented performer who returned home to grace her stage and screen. The radiant Basitsana Khumalo and the dazzling Craig Obani.
Good evening, South Africa. What a wonderful night this is going to be. And what a wonderful introduction to the celebration of 50 years of Miss South Africa.
Absolutely, perfectly in keeping with our theme of glamour and our salute to all that's best about South African women. Please, can we have another round of applause for the talents of the Debbie Rakusen dancers and our lovely ladies?
We have some incredible talents on display this evening, as well as our really stunning, stunning finalists. We'll be introducing them to you as the evening progresses.
Now, of course, Basitsana, you know this turf, having walked the walk here not too many years ago. So tell us a little bit about what you think the girls are feeling and what they're going through right now.
Oh, Craig, it is quite nerve-wracking, but also the scrutiny of the judges puts a lot of pressure. But then again, it is such an incredible opportunity for any young woman.
Well, you mentioned them, so let's meet this year's judges and find out how the process works.
Judging began at Sun International Headquarters in Sandton, where the preliminary judges, under the guidance of Sonia Rasiti Oshri, had the awesome task of sorting through the thousands of entry forms from all over the country. Judging in the regional heats was done in person, giving the aspirant Miss South Africa entrants a chance to impress the judges with the force of their personalities and interests. Then it was on to Sun City for the next judging rounds. While these hopefuls were graded on much, much more than appearance alone, the contestants still had to parade before the team, face a barrage of questions, and eventually do the dreaded swimwear walk. At last, the finalists were chosen, leading to tonight's glittering event.
The judges for Miss South Africa 2007 were carefully chosen for their specialized knowledge and commitment to this pageant. The decisions they make tonight will change the lives of our finalists, and we cannot stress highly enough how very important that very task is when they give the golden nod to the winner. Of course, our judges and our finalists have all been transported around the country, courtesy of Nationwide Airlines.
The first of our judges is Dr. Precious Moloi Motsepe, a graduate of Wits Medical School. She is today a businesswoman and chairperson of African Fashion International. Rise. Let us see you.
So Risha Naidu is a DJ and television actress and a former Miss India SA. Today she's an instantly recognizable face as co-presenter of SABC2's Eastern Mosaic.
Rake Neidling is one of the most successful swimmers ever in South Africa. I know. And a little bit later on, when the swimwear parade happens, Rake and I are going to be donning our white Speedo so we can put to rest this myth that Rake Neidling looks better in a Speedo than Craig Obani. He's a three-time Olympian. Yeah, I can see you. He's a three-time Olympian. He has gold and a world record from the 2004 Olympics in Athens. He ranks in the international top 10 in several swimming categories. Rake Neidling.
The lovely Tami Ngubeni has been a television presenter and is founder and managing director of her own media company. In addition, she also happens to be the editor of O, the Oprah magazine, South Africa.
Esmeray Vedeman has both a BCom and a postgraduate journalism degree to her name, both awarded cum laude. She is currently a triple thread, being the editor of You, Heesgenoot, and Drum magazines. Ladies and gentlemen, our celebrity judges, please. Now, the sharp-eyed among you may have noticed that both Basitsana and I are wearing the white ribbon, the symbol of 16 days of activism against women and child abuse. Now, this evening definitely celebrates South African women, so please, let's make sure that we do all we can to stop the terrible crime of abuse.
I couldn't agree with you more on that one, Craig. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the tension backstage is electric with anticipation, and it's sure to build as the evening progresses. But that doesn't mean you can't sit back, relax, and enjoy the evening with us. South Africa is indeed blessed with great, great talent, and coming up shortly, we have the incredible talents of Thabo and Nhlanhla Mdluli.
stay tuned for more of this golden anniversary celebration of Miss South Africa 2007.
Chant Cellular and Vodacom for you. Proud airtime sponsor to Miss South Africa and Miss Teen SA 2007. For all your cellular contract, prepaid and data needs, visit any Chant Cellular or Vodacom for you store.
Photographic is extremely proud to be the official photographer and sponsor for the Miss South Africa and Miss S18 pageants. Over the past 15 years, we have been privileged to be the official photographers at numerous momentous occasions and delivered many historic images. If you're planning any event, launch, or function that requires great photographs, you need to contact Peter Morey Photographic.
The rules for work have changed dramatically. It's no longer about how smart we are, but how we handle ourselves and each other at work. Professional Impressions focus on developing the most sought-after skills in the workplace. With 32 years of experience, our team of consultants will assist you to get your verbal and written message across clearly, build better working relationships, deal with angry, abusive people, project a professional brand. So for success, contact Professional Impressions.
Welcome back to Miss South Africa 2007.
So tonight we're celebrating 50 years of Miss South Africa, and come with us now as we go back to the very beginning. That time of poodle skirts, ducktails, and carefully combed quiffs.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the incredible Thabo and Nhlanhla Mdluli.
Baby,
The superb talents of Thabo and Nhlanhla Mdluli. Nhlanhla, incidentally, wearing JJ Schoeman. Give them a big round of applause. Let's hear for the Debbie Rakusen dancers as well. And please welcome back your co-host, Masitsana Khumalo.
The history of the Miss South Africa is a rich and complex one, I might add, often reflecting the history of our country. Like golden threads woven through the fabric come shining names, still reflecting a brilliant light. In this golden year, please welcome some of our golden girls. In 1953, Ingrid Mills won the Miss Golden Jubilee pageant and made the semi-finals of the Miss Universe competition. Part of her prize package included a film studio contract, and she appeared in the Hollywood film Yankee Pasha. In 1958, Penny Coolan became the first Miss South Africa to be crowned Miss World. In those days, there were no competitive pageant. Penny learned of her win at a luncheon with the editors. In 1967, Wendy Belandon represented South Africa at Miss Universe competition in Miami Beach, USA. She acted in local films, taught modeling internationally, and became a successful makeup artist and casting agent. By 1970, international opposition to apartheid policies resulted in dual representation at Miss World. Pearl Jansen was first Miss Africa South and was placed second at the second Miss World competition of that year. Annelien Kriel was crowned Miss South Africa in 1974 and was first runner-up in Miss World. However, the winner was dethroned 4 days later, being an unwed mother, and Annelien became the second Miss South Africa to hold the Miss World title. In 1975, Gail Anthony was named Miss RSA, the complimentary sister title of that time. She too went on to the Miss Universe contest and worked as a model and a beauty therapist before moving into public relations for many years. Also in 1975, Vera Johns was crowned Miss South Africa. Controversy struck on the eve of the Miss World competition when she was disqualified over a technicality to do with dual citizenship. She later married All Black rugby player Alan Sutherland, and together they became leading thoroughbred racehorse breeders. What a lineup, and what incredible memories these women evoke. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our finalists as they parade in day wear against the backdrop of that decade of flower power, peace, and love. And to accompany them musically, here's Denim.
You're just too good to be true.
My name is Avumile Qongqo. I'm 21 years old, I'm from Queenstown, and I'm a student and a part-time model. I'm still studying, but my modeling has taken me to overseas, to Australia and New Zealand. And I see myself in 5 years' time happily married to a beautiful husband, with beautiful kids, and just businesswoman and living a harmonious life.
I'm 21 years old and I'm a proud Capetonian and I'm a student. I really love sports. I play action netball, social netball, Western Province netball. I do surfing, horse riding, soccer, and a little bit of hockey. My favorite possession is my charm bracelet. It was given to me by my friends and family, and each charm represents something new.
is all for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you.
I'm Kerry Histerman, I'm 23 years old and I'm from Johannesburg. I'm currently studying my honours in brand management and I do part-time modelling. I enjoy swimming and going to the gym, doing spinning. I also like branding and design books. In the future, I see myself to be a brand manager of a cosmetics company and hopefully to be involved in a charity.
I'm Tansey, I'm 23 years old from Johannesburg. I'm a professional model and dancer. What makes me happy is seeing someone else being happy. My hobbies are dancing, singing, modeling, acrobatics, jazz and hip hop. I see myself owning my own clothing brand, modeling internationally and owning my own events company.
Dumela, I am Madhava Maila, 22 years old, from Limpopo province. I'm a fuel coordinator for an oil company and I'm currently residing in Johannesburg. What makes people special to me is their individuality. In 5 years from now, I see myself as a very successful woman, owning considerable amount of shares in oil industry and running a youth leadership academy.
If you knew Peggy Sue, then you'd know why I feel blue without Peggy. Oh, my Peggy Sue. And I love you, girl. I love you, Peggy Sue. I love you, Peggy Sue, with a smile so rare and true. Oh, Peggy. Oh, my Peggy Sue. I love you, girl. I love you, Peggy Sue.
Peggy. Hi, I'm 21-year-old Delani Buerta from Rameswif, Johannesburg. I'm an internationally qualified somatologist. I love doing somatology. My passion is reflexology because I've got an interesting talent, which is healing hands. And I believe I'm quite good with that. Something I consider absolutely fabulous would have to be the butterflies in my stomach when I'm in love.
Peggy Sue, oh, with a smile so rare and true, oh, Peggy. Oh, my Peggy Sue. I love you, girl. I love you, Peggy Sue. Peggy Sue, Peggy Sue.
pretty, 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 pretty Peggy Sue, oh Peggy. Oh my Peggy Sue.
Now you may be wondering just what it is that the winner of Miss South Africa 2007 will be receiving as her prize package, apart from the coveted title, of course. No need to speculate anymore. We are going to show you right now.
Miss South Africa has the pleasure of receiving one of the most valuable prize packages worldwide. Varsity College will grant her an education bursary to the value of 90,000 rand, as well as a 30,000 rand bursary donated to a charity of her choice. At Vega, the Brand Communication School will offer her an A to Z of branding workshop. Professional Impressions will assist Miss South Africa in creating powerful and lasting impressions. She will stay in touch throughout her reign using Chat Cellular and Vodacom for you with 18,000 rands worth of airtime. Miss South Africa will receive hair care products from L'Oreal Professional and Mizani worth 10,000 rand. While Gary Rong will keep this year's winner looking fabulous with hair services to the value of 44,000 rand. She will receive professional hand, foot and body care treatment courtesy of Dream Nails and Body. Miss South Africa will get beach gorgeous with the Caribbean Tans new
sample its regal delights and its royal attention to detail. Or the Cascades Hotel, whose beauty overflows from elegant bedrooms to glorious gardens and a private beach. The fantasy world of the Sun City Hotel. Non-stop gaming action, breathtaking shows, restaurants and nightlife. Family fun in the cabanas on the banks of Waterworld. Daily excitement for kids at Camp Quena and Animal World. Sun City, Africa's kingdom of pleasure.
We continue now this anniversary celebration by calling back onto the stage some of our previous winners. These former title holders show us that they definitely still have what it takes. Let's go. In 1978, Yolanda Kloppers was the first Miss South Africa to fall foul of politics when she was refused entry into the Miss World. But Yolanda was acclaimed at home as a model and diet and image consultant. 1979, Veronica Wilson took the Miss RSA title. She represented this country at Miss Universe and also starred in a movie with Anthony Quinn. She too had an enviable modeling career and formed an events management company with some former Miss South Africa title holders. The Miss South Africa of 1979 was Karen Sickle, who went on to a successful career as a model. She currently lives in Johannesburg and works for a developer. The 1980 Miss South Africa was Sandy McChrystal, who followed up her reign with a 20-year modeling career, as well as her own successful lifestyle and interior decor store, much loved by Joburg residents. Miss South Africa 1981, Linda Phillips married in 1986. She is the proud mother of two children. She currently lives in Durban. Odette Scrooby took the title in 1982 and competed in Miss Universe in Peru. A helicopter pilot today, she is involved with Game Lodge development and upliftment programs in the Northern Province. Cape Townian Sandra De Meyer also holds a title from 1982. After managing a conference center for some years, she went on to a career with her own promotional clothing company. In 1984 saw Lorna Porchita crowned as Miss South Africa. An international modeling career followed for this former maths teacher. Today she does events management for the fashion and beauty industry. In 1985 was the year of Andrea Stelzer, but political concerns denied her a chance at Miss Universe. She later won Miss Germany in 1988 and then became a television presenter, a writer, and today has her own real estate company. Vilma van der Bijl Tapanlis was Miss South Africa 1987. Today she has her own business, is a pharmacist and a tireless campaigner for the Red Cross Children's Fund. Michelle Bruce topped the decade in 1989. Today, she is an environmental and ecological activist, carrying her concerns into natural and organic beauty products with the import company that she shares with her husband. Then the 90s were ushered in by Suzette van der Merwe. She's written a book called The Secret of Contentment and currently works at Vodacom and is executive head of corporate social investment. So let's have some wonderful applause now. It really is great to see all these shining examples of South African women here on the stage tonight. There's so much more still to come, including the much dreaded Rake Nietling Swimwear Parade.
Stay tuned for more of this golden anniversary celebration of Miss South Africa 2007.
Money saving tip number 18. Use less electricity. At Tempest 6 Car Hire, there's nothing we won't do to bring you ridiculously low rates.
Tempest 6, it's pashash, it's good value.
Okay, Craig, we move now to that very daunting segment for our finalists, but I suppose one that the audience and indeed our viewers have been waiting for.
Absolutely, I would have to agree with you. The Swimwear Parade is always an event much anticipated in these competitions, but I'm sure very, very frightening for our ladies.
Oh yes, therefore I implore our audience to please give your warmest applause for our finalists as we go into our Swimwear Parade, with each of our finalists wearing a Speedo creation. And if you're wondering about their golden glow, it's by Cosmetics and Caribbean 10.
Say that too much of anything is not good for you, baby. But I don't know about that. There's many times that with love, we've shared love and made love. It doesn't seem to me like it's enough. It's not enough. It's just not enough.
Oh, my darling, I can't get enough of your love, babe. Girl, I don't know why. Can't get enough of your love, babe. My darling, I can't get enough of your love, babe. Girl, I don't know why. Can't get enough of your love, babe. Yeah.
Let's rock this joint. Once again.
and OB. Wait for me, peep out my homie.
Take off all your clothes and your sexy coat. Leave it on the backseat, cause we're going out. And all the blimey feet, gather round your dress, make you look sexy when we're going out.
Right now,
can't go
without you, girl.
Found you, girl. I want you.
I want you right now.
Need you.
I need you right now.
Can't go
without you, girl.
Found you.
Yeah.
Want you.
I want you right now.
Need you.
I need you right now.
Can't go
without you, girl.
Found you, girl.
I
want you.
I want you right now.
So when no one will buy, cause I've been rich folk and only get it on late by. Baby, we ain't catching eyes, we blinding eyes. Where we hit the limelight, no compromise. Baby, tonight you ain't a princess, you a queen-cess. I name's a Mr. and Mrs. Oh my goodness, I'm your Tony Montana, my be a princess. My nose been dope like we ain't got no bills left.
Baby, tonight is the night
and I feel alright. I got my lady and my dough stacks is right. Tonight is love and peace, me and my wife. Only thing I look forward to more is the
end of the night.
I want you right now.
Need you.
I need you right now.
Can't go
without you, girl.
Found you, girl.
I
want you.
I want you right now.
Need you.
I need you right now.
Can't go
without you, girl.
Found you, girl.
I.
How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Let's hear it for Jamali, who were dressed by Gideon, Loiso, Orbita, Victor, the Debbie Rakusin dancers, and let's hear it especially for our finalists tonight. More style and magic coming up after this.
We'll return in a moment with more of the excitement and glamour here at Miss South Africa 2007.
The rules for work have changed dramatically. It's no longer about how smart we are, but how we handle ourselves and each other at work. Professional Impressions focus on developing the most sought-after skills in the workplace. With 32 years of experience, our team of consultants will assist you to get your verbal and written message across clearly, build better working relationships, deal with angry, abusive people, project a professional brand. So for success, contact Professional Impressions.
Well, that's the idea. It's Lip Fusion with micro-injected collagen, the first lip plumper that actually puts real collagen into your lips, plumping your pout instantly. Nighttime therapy, plumping pencils, and 14 sheer shimmery glosses, all with Lip Fusion's breakthrough plumping formula. No needles, no waiting, no kidding. Find it in pretty sets for the holidays.
Margaret, Annalene, Vilma, Batsatsani, Jackie, Joanne, and the list goes on. Over the past 5 decades, Heyskanut, you and Drum have been part of Miss South Africa and brought you the story behind the country's most beautiful women, from the glitz and glamour to their everyday lives. Celebrating 50 years of Miss South Africa with Heyskanut, you and Drum. The story continues tonight.
Welcome back to Miss South Africa 2007.
The annual Miss South Africa event does not forget its social responsibility and an awareness of issues and concerns that affect our country. Tapolokho AIDS Hospice has been officially adopted by the Miss South Africa pageant as its primary charity.
Tapolokho is an AIDS hospice situated in beautiful surroundings and landscaped gardens in the Northwest Province, providing palliative care for patients in the terminal stages of the disease. It also provides support for the families of the resident patients. Excitement was high as the finalists arrived on a visit to be greeted by Bishop Kevin Dowling and his hard-working staff. It was a highly emotional time as each of the Miss South Africa hopefuls learnt of the achievements and goals of Tapolokho. Then it was a chance for the finalists to bring their charm and cheery smiles to the patients in the wards. A word of comfort here, a shared joke there, the empathy was immediate and complete. Even the simple act of holding hands or providing a soothing caress to someone in distress meant so much. Moved and inspired, the finalists took time to encourage the staff as well, and then posed for an official photograph before making their way back to Sun City for further assignments and judging.
I know from speaking to our ladies that that was an extremely moving and very touching experience for all of them. Now they say that everything old is new again. It's actually the words of an old song. And here to prove that very fact with a classic melody that's come back again big time and is once more Mr. Wonderful, Thabo Mdluli. Thank you, Thabo Mdluli. A beautiful version of a fantastic song. Thank you, my friend. Right, we turn now to our anniversary parade of previous winners of Miss South Africa title. We're focusing now on the last decade and a half. Let's do it. The Miss South Africa of 1992 was Amy Kleinhans. Her degree in education led to her work in that field with schools in underprivileged communities and education training. She also has a promotion company and is patron of Lifeline Childline in the Western Cape. She's my co-host tonight, Basetsana Khumalo. She was Miss South Africa in 1994. She has diverse interests as an entrepreneur in the mining sector and property development. She's a television producer, has a clothing and cosmetics range, and has recently been elected president of the Business Women's Association. 1995 was the year of Bernalee Daniel. She has her own promotions company, works for an international company as an executive accounts manager, and is a patron of the Steps charity in our very own country. Peggy Sue Khumalo won the title in 1996. She studied and later worked in the United Kingdom as a fixed income analyst, but has since returned home to South Africa where she works as an investments consultant. 1997's winner was Kareshni Naika, who was the only South African of Indian heritage to win the crown. Initially, she worked as a television presenter for both local and international companies. Today, she is a trustee for various corporations and a pharmacist who works in the field of social responsibility by building hospitals and clinics in rural areas. Kareshni. Sonia Rasiti Oshri, one of our judges, took the title in 1998. She holds an honors degree in education and has worked as a television presenter in addition to her strong commitment, very strong commitment, to the Miss South Africa pageant. Then the last year of the 90s gave us Heather Hamilton. She's a senior investment professional for an asset management company. She's also a show jumper and a supporter of Riding for the Disabled. Joanne Strauss was studying for her law degree when she won the title in 2000. She completed her degree and now is a partner in an investment company, as well as being a popular television presenter. In 2001, Vanessa Carrera took the Miss South Africa title. She later moved into television presentation, as well as managing her own events company. Miss South Africa 2002 was Cindy Nell. She has her own promotions company. She was a presenter for the SABC. She works in social upliftment programs, particularly those concerned with the development of talented young girls. She's also recently launched her own product, Caribbean Tan, which incidentally is one of the sponsors of the Miss South Africa pageant. And she was a runner-up to the Miss Universe. Cindy. In 2003, Joan Ramakoshi was named winner. She works in PR and marketing and broke gender stereotypes by becoming the brand manager for Sundowns Football Club. She also supports a home for AIDS orphans in Mamelodi. In 2004's crown went to Claudia Henkel. After a stint as a fundraiser for charity and her ongoing public appearances as a speaker, she has recently returned to university to complete her law degree. And finally, it's Thuli Sitoli that brings us up to 2005. She was Miss South Africa in 2005. In her reigning year, she was a patron of the Tapalogo AIDS Hospice and worked as a fundraiser for them. She has also returned to her university studies towards a career in the construction industry. Well, there you have it. Our fifth decade of Miss South Africa, each one deserving of your applause. But it doesn't stop there. Coming up is much, much more enchantment as the ladies of 2007, our finalists, don their evening wear.
This is the Sun City Super Bowl and the spectacular Miss South Africa 2007.
We'll be right back. dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.